You're right, folks, and welcome to an episode of the Ajax Let's Play. Don't forget down below, if you're enjoying this series, hit the subscribe button down below to... Well, as if you're enjoying it, hit the like button first. If you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button. And if you want to do both, then that's fantastic. So yeah, hopefully you're feeling good, better than I'm feeling right now. You may be wondering, why are we seeing the AZ game? Well, for more than one reason. First of all, is I don't like ending the season with three games to spare and then cut into this season review. Second of all, I've not had time to record a video much recently because of illness. I've had a really bad either stomach bug or an IBS flare, so it's been difficult to record videos because we're not feeling great. Just sit there not doing anything, and it's just really difficult to record, and you know, when you're feeling unwell. And thirdly, is I want to talk about the style of videos going into the second season, about a possible change I'm thinking of doing, because I've got more time to record now, because I'm not doing FIFA content, I'm not doing as many Let's Plays on this channel, so I've got more time on my hands to record these videos in, so I want to talk about something in the video as well while we're at it. And also, next episode will be a season review, and I thought I'd rather do the talking about the content style change in this video, rather than doing it in the season analysis video, which is going to be done tomorrow, which I'll be doing tonight after we finish this, where I go into more depth and look at every player. I thought it's going to be a long video. It's going to be a long video anyway. I don't want to make it even longer by talking about something I could talk about in this video. So yeah, we are changing this. I've changed these settings, guys, on the OBS recording as well. So let me know, guys, if everything's okay. You shouldn't notice a difference. But hopefully, everything's okay. So we've got a couple of games to go through, see if you're last with us to talk about, and then we'll get to the main event, which is AZ away in the final game of the season. So it would appear like our players are camera shy, because they're not 6 goals past FC Utrecht. 2 from Chris Promise, of course, 1 from David Neres, and then Haaland decided he was bored in the second half and decided to score that trick. It was just one of those games where you just sit there thinking, you know what, I don't have to do anything in this game, you're all perfect. The only person that didn't get over 8.0 rating was the goalkeeper, which is actually pretty good, because you don't want your keeper getting high ratings, but you don't want too low either. So about 7.1 is about right, because it means you ain't doing out, which is good, unless it's a 5.8, and you're thinking, yeah, not good. But yeah, perfect performance rate, just looked really good. We did try a 4-2-3-1 today. I want to try doing that, because I'm thinking, a lot of times in my games, I go with like one formation all the time, and I think it is a good idea to actually have two, and I think this team can play both. So it does. It opens up more avenues of signings and more adaptability, because there will be points we have to play the DM, but I don't think we need to in this league most of the time. But we can debate that in the analysis. But yeah, 6-1, great result there, and just nice to get a few goals and relax a little bit. That continued against VV Venlo. 4-1 victory there. 2 for Haaland, 2 for Joel Veltman. The guy not scored a goal all season, and in like the space of 4 minutes, he scores 2 from set pieces. I was like, what the? He's like, can you do this earlier? it's hilarious. Literally, he's the living embodiment of the whole phrase of you wait for a bus and 2 come along at once. Literally, here, that's what he's like. He went for a goal all season, he scores 2 in a meaningless game. But again, 2 good headers, and it's a 4-1 victory there. Haaland again, just, you know, just dominating. Again, 4-2-3-1 was dominant. We created a lot of chances, got a lot of goals in it. So I feel like I can do 4-2-3-1. And yeah, it's a pretty good result for us there. And I'm happy with the goals I scored. Hopefully they can do it today against AZ. But it probably won't be the same. So league table, guys, we're 10 points clear. The league's won last episode, of course. We've got 2 top goal scorers. I'd love to get Promise to get another goal, because to make sure that he stays in the top 3. Because David Neres is right behind him, and I'm just worried about if he gets a goal or two in the final game of the season. I would like our guys to be top. So I'd like David Neres to maybe get a couple today, and then Promise to get one as well. So the top 3 is all our players. That'd be awesome if we could do that. And but we'll have to wait and see. Haaland on 26. If you can get 4 goals and get 30, it'd be brilliant, wouldn't it? But yeah, we can still affect PSV. So if we lose this game today and PSV don't win, we could potentially knock them out of Champions League spot, which I don't really want to do, but it'd be a nice bonus if we did lose. So we are going to 4-2-3-1 today, which is fantastic, which is going really well for us right now. I'm just going to change this around a little bit. I'm going to bring in Promise. Oh no, he's been knocked. Can Mandy play there really well? Apparently so. So that's interesting. We'll give him a run out. It's time to experiment really today, but I want to keep the decent players out there, you know, to give him a run out. I'm going to actually put Partey in there today. And left back, I mean, lack of options, really. I don't really trust my fullbacks, to be brutally honest with you. I mean, he has got decent potential. But I do feel like I just need more pace in the back in the back line. And it's something I'm going to try and address in the summer, if possible. But I'm not going to go and buy players for the sake of buying them. One thing I've learned about FM is I don't want to just buy players for the sake of it. They've got to be top quality. And there's one guy which I'm doing a pre-contract agreement for, which if I sign guys, could be a really good signing for us. And I'll talk about that in the next first season episode of season two if he signs. So essentially, while this game's going on, guys, I'm going to talk about what we're going to be doing potentially with the style of content, because like I said, I am, because of the content changes, I'm doing one series on my second channel, which is Jedi Fallen Order. I'm doing this one daily, apart from Sundays. And I'm doing Stars of Tomorrow, which is a very casual series. I don't have to even have to be on the PC for more than, I have to talk for more than 10 minutes in that video. I'm considering doing double live comms. And I think it'd be, get more games in there. Instead of showing like the dead space in matches where nothing really happens, I could just skip through those periods and show the more exciting bits of a game. Going on, hit it. Oh. So, basically, I can't really demonstrate it now because I've not really got a game to do. But basically, this period here, I will just cut it out. And if this highlight here, for example, let's see if this isn't reading anything. So, Dest finds Akunjayek, outright to Dest. Dest crosses the in towards Nevinerez. I might show that. But then, if it goes like 10, 15, 20 minutes without a highlight, I won't show anything. So I'll show the key, what I think are the key moments in the games as we go forward. So let me know, guys, if you guys want to see that or not. It just means we have more scope to do more games. And it would, I think, for me personally, that highlight there, I won't show it. This bit here, I won't show it. This is pointless showing. Nothing's happening. So it would just get through the games quicker and show more matches. So if we've got those two games that I can't decide which is live com, doesn't matter, I can just do two live comms together and show them both. So let me know, guys, what you think down in the comment section if you want to see that or not. I'm leaning towards doing it anyway, but I always like to make sure you guys get a say in what we do here. I'm 1-0 down, fantastic. That is the downside to the 4-2-3-1, is the counter attacks are, mind you, is it fall to feet? Is it formation based, or is it the fact that Joe Veltman just Alvarez just can't deal with him, and then lack of support? I don't know. I mean, I think it is formation based slightly, but I'd like to do 4-2-3-1 more often. But it has worked in the other two games, so I'm not going to judge again. We are sitting a bit too deep here, which I don't like. And Akunjayek again, you'd go to him fullback. We're just not getting tight to people. The walking past, I'm not even there. That's 2-0, isn't it? Is he offside? Well, we need to just change this. Go to fairly wide for starters. Out of possession, just, yeah, I mean, we are pressing it high. We're just not really getting close to them, which is, the only problem with pressing high I've got is the fact that my defenders are not exactly quick. And then they will get behind. It's going to happen when you play high pressure press and get in behind and, you know, press up high. So I'm just worried that if they do beat our offside trap or beat our line, they're going to struggle to get back in cover. Haaland, oh, what a player he is. 35 goals, folks. I mean, the guy's have, I think he's got double assists as well. We can go into that next episode. What about Akunjayek? Akunjayek seems to be doing better in the camp position. Now, the reason why I'm thinking going 4-2-3-1 is simply because I just don't think he gets the goal assist. Again, we can go into more of that detail of that in next episode. Haaland's in again here. Oh. It's not the fact he missed it, it's the fact that he didn't get enough power behind to me. It looks like a really like weak shot, to be honest. That's the problem I have with it. It's not the fact he missed it, which granted can happen. It's the fact that he's like gone there. He's teased me, and then he's just kind of like just passed it to the goalkeeper, you know. And it's a bit naff, if I'm honest with you. Akunjayek, good ball to David Neres in the penalty. He's a frustrating player, David Neres, but I think he's had a good season. In fact, I'm pretty sure he has had a good season. Did you just see Ajax the second in the table? I appear to be losing their match. I've not seen a score. I've not been looking at it really, to be fair. See, that's when you should get a foot in there and get the ball, but then it's really poor. Get it clear, Dest. Now there's a break on here with Bande. Now then, he's got options in the middle. He's basically Erling Haaland. Can he find him, though? He's got a penalty. Oh, no, has he got a penalty? No, he hasn't. It's a corner kick. I thought he'd get a penalty. I thought the game would pause for a penalty there. Ball comes in. Haaland, far post! They've done better since they went to more of a more urgent pressing on them. But I'm just worried about the ball over the top. And the midfield, yeah, see, you got to go to him, dude. Great tackle. Oh, God. That was good. That was like a really good moment, and then they shit one in like 5 seconds. It's like, get the ball. Wait, no, we haven't. Oh, Hakim Ziyech. Well done. Bande. Oh. This is when we see the pressure on. Again, they're backing off them, and that's a ball over the top. But then that's what they're going to try and do. I want them to do that more. But if I can get a... I think two fast setbacks. I see one on the cover who can really do that for us. Good ball by Tonali, that. It's really good, actually. David Neres, down the left-hand side. Can he find a ball in the box here? He beat his man. And this time it is a penalty. I thought we got one earlier. We've got one now. And who's taking the penalty? I think it's Erling Haaland taking it, I think. It is Erling Haaland. Can he find the corner with this, at least? That's all I asked for from penalty spots, is to hit the corner. And he emphatically does. For 2-1, look at that goal tally. I mean, that is insane. For me, from a guy who has problems with strikers on last... three games with FM consistently getting goals. This is actually really, really nice to see. Not 3-1. Not yet, hopefully. Hopefully we'll get that. Just nice to see a free scoring striker. With the moving the channel trait on him, which is something I've always struggled with. So, oh, hang on, got free kick. Don't make a change on free kick. He's going to go for, yeah, if this goes in, oh my. I mean, what are we doing at the back? I mean, what are you the ball watching? But that sums up free kicks for us. They'll get those. We will not do jack no shit from a free kick, which is really frustrating. I don't know why that is the case. I really don't know why we struggle with free kicks. We've got a good free kick taker, which is bizarre. Tonali kills it in, cleared. Partey, Hakim Ziyech. I like him. I just don't know where to play him. I think I know where to play him, but it's like, ball in the box. Did Bandy just run away from that one? Or did he get pushed out of the way? I hope it was the latter. But again, they are third in the table. So, it's just frustrating how the goal went in. Tadic can come on. Van der Beek can come on. And... get Blind on, because, you know, why the hell not? Can we get from a corner kick? I don't score on FIFA, but can I score on FM? Tadic, come on, good ball in here, bro. That was a shocking ball, but it fell to Erling Haaland, who, again, I think came close to the header there, just scoring another one, which is pretty cool. But it looks like it's going to be a 2-2 draw, which is frustrating, but not a big surprise that we drew against the third best team in the league. Arguably the fourth best team in the league. So, these are results I don't really get worried about. It's the draws against this team's bottom of the table that pissed me off. But you know what? I mean, we didn't concede goals in the way I thought we would, which would be like over the top. And we did do better on the pressing in the second half. So, unlucky boy wasn't our day. I'm not going to be too harsh on them because it's a dead rubber of a game anyway. So, yeah. So that is the end of Season 1, guys. And I've really enjoyed this first season. If you have as well, hit the subscribe button down below and like button as well to help support this series. We do upload it on a daily basis. Sunday is my day off. I may not stick to that all the time. It depends what I can get recorded. If I'm way ahead in recording for some reason, I may upload on Sundays. But I think I'm going to keep Sundays my unofficial day off on the series, just so you guys can catch up and I get a bit of a break, just to, you know, if I can't record, it's like, well, I've got two episodes live, but I don't have to record on Sunday, so I don't have to upload one, just to get a bit of a break. But luckily I'm ahead of things right now. So next episode, we're going to go in more in depth on the whole analysis of the squad and the overview. I may also look at the other leagues as well, because I'm curious as well about what's going on in Premier League, Serie A, and that kind of thing, because there are loads on the game. So yeah, thank you so much. I want to see where the league table finished. Just a quick glancing view. I'm just curious to see who... Ha! Screw you, PSG. FC Groningen are in the Champions League. I think we may have to raid PSV with some players. But again, that's something we'll get into next episode. But if you enjoyed this video, hit the like button down below. I'll see you tomorrow for another upload. It'll be a season review with no webcam. Just for shits. Why not? And yeah, and let me know, guys, down in the comment section about the style change. I will say that the big matches that are like one-off matches might be still in real life commed. Cup finals will be full live com. There won't be no editing in it. But I think for most of the season, it may be just be edited live comms. If we get to back end of the season, like if we go to the fixtures, let's say, I don't know, like that final game there is, let's say we're playing, we've got Hercules, say we did a live com here, right, against Hercules, for example. Then next live com would be Hellenveen and PSV. Next to our pick. If the PSV game is like a big game for the title, I would focus on that one game, more than likely. But your thoughts down below, guys, what you prefer to see. I really like this save. It's been a dream of, not a dream, been a, something I've wanted to do for a while. And to do what we've done in the first season is actually, for me, as a really average FM player, I'm very happy with that. So I will see you tomorrow for another upload. Don't forget down below, leave a comment about the style, the content style change that I'm going to be doing and your thoughts on that. But until next time, thank you so much for watching. Take it away, Elton. Bye-bye.